Yeah, 0.0 is all about memory compression, compressing data inside the memory. And what we do is we interrupt the path from the processing unit to the memory, and we compress the data. And when you read the data, it's decompressed as well, which means it's totally transparent to the applications and the software running in the system. But we create three times more memory than really physically available in the system. So that means you can process a lot more data, you can save money, you can get higher performance by adding our technology inside your system. And the origin is research at Chalmers University. We've been part of and supported by the Euroserver project, and we're now engaging with our first customers within machine learning, image recognition, where being able to process a lot more information at the same time is very crucial to handle the backlog of data that's been gathered in all of these big data systems, where the volume of data is actually growing faster than we have the time to process it. But we also have potential interest all the way down to budget smartphones, but we're focusing on the higher end applications at the moment. It's really exciting. This is really our first official occasion where we really talk about our technology. So great to be here, and we're looking forward to the next sessions and the other events here at HighPeak. One of the projects we're working with at the moment is an image recognition project. And what you do is basically you teach a computer system to recognize something. And you don't do it by telling the system, this is a car, this is a dog. Instead, you show the system pictures of dogs and pictures of cars. And you show the system thousands and thousands of pictures. And so the system learns how to identify certain objects. And then you show the system another picture and you tell them, is there a car? Tell us what's in this picture. And the system tells you, it's a dog. Sorry, it was wrong. It's a car. Okay. But every time the system learns, and this is done by mimicking the brain in a system. And the more data you can feed this artificial brain, the quicker it learns, the more images it can recognize and process. And that's one of the projects we're actually talking about here in the booth as well, learning how to recognize objects in pictures. And so that's one of the real applications where we add value, because these self-learning systems can process more information quicker thanks to our technology.